Welcome, my dear daydreamers. Thank you for joining me for this little arty AMA video. I'm so glad you're here. Today you'll see the painting process for my tea tail video cover artwork. Grab yourself a cup of tea and settle in, or put this video on in the background while you work on your own art project or story. You can't see it on camera, but right now I'm drinking Witches Wassail tea, which is a new blend in my Merry Meat bundle with two other blends. It smells like mulled wine and tastes like fruit mince pies. It's delicious. Firstly, you might be wondering exactly who I am and what I have to offer you here. I'm Sarah Louise, artist, creative writer, and tea witch at Bright Witch Brews. This little intro might already have raised a couple more questions, like, why do I call myself a tea witch? I use this term quite playfully. I have an eclectic mix of spiritual practices and interests, and I make and sell tea, so it seemed like a fitting label. Your next question might be, what is Bright Witch Brews? Bright Witch is my business, an online tea shop where I sell blends that I personally absolutely adore. I've called almost every single blend my personal favourite at one point or another, and drink this tea every single day myself. The logical question after that would be, why tea? When I was first starting my business, someone said to me, everyone who loves tea already has a cupboard full of it, so why make yet another tea brand? When it comes to tea, I really value the sensory experience of it. The smells and flavours, the aesthetic of the loose leaf blends, the ritual of making a fresh cup or pot of tea and having it right there in a beautiful ceramic mug warming my hands. I love that tea can be as simple as you want it to be or dressed up into an elegant social art form. Tea is just this tangible, tactile comfort that's accessible to most people and comes in so many forms and flavours. When I started Bright Witch Tea, I wanted to create blends that were as truly delightful to the senses as possible. I wanted to work with flavours that I personally loved, and I wanted to share those with others. I added edible sparkles to the blend so each mug was like a little piece of the swirling cosmos in your hands. I wanted something I could lose my imagination to while grounding my physical senses in scent and flavour and warmth and glittering visuals. I wanted to feel like magic drinking it, and I wanted that feeling from my friends and family and customers. Now, tea isn't all that I do or make. I'm also a visual artist and a creative writer, and I share some of these works on social media and to my email list. I recently connected with Samantha of Samantha Johnson Storytelling on Instagram. As someone who is completely new to my work and my brand, she had a few wonderful questions for me, which actually inspired this AMA. Her first question for me was, are you a storyteller? Yes, I definitely do consider myself a storyteller. I write short poems and tiny tea time tales, which are short stories intended as a brief, cozy daydream escape during a tea break. I share these on social media, to my email list, and more recently on my new Patreon feed. I've been writing stories for almost as long as I've been reading. I've studied narrative craft both in short courses or uni electives or self-study for over a decade now, I want to say. Currently, my absolute favourite resource for learning storycraft has been Rachel Stevens' YouTube channel and her paid course, The Story Magic Academy. There just isn't a better name for it. It's truly magic. This video isn't at all sponsored, it's just that her course is the reason I feel confident enough to finally write novel-length works after years and years and years of world-building. Which actually ties in with Samantha's next question for me. Do you write tangible books? Yes and no. I am currently writing a novel. I'm publishing the chapters serially as I write them, though it's currently all in digital format, published on my website, to my email list, and on Patreon. So not tangible per se, yet. Once I finished all the chapters, I would love to illustrate them and then print an actual tangible book. I was for a brief time publishing physical booklets of my tiny tea tales, but with hard lockdowns here in Melbourne, the logistics of making that happen were just a bit too tricky. So I've put that idea on hold for the time being, but I hope to return to it in the future. Samantha's next question was, are you a tea seller? Yes, I am a tea seller. A fair question to ask when my social feeds are full of poetry and art. And you might be wondering how all of these things tie in. Art, tea, stories, what's bringing all of these things together? And the answer is basically my love of daydreaming. I truly think of daydreams and imagination as a form of magic. We all have our own completely private worlds that we spin within our minds. We live in entirely individual landscapes of sensory impressions, memories, stories, philosophies, and fantasy. Daydreams for me are a way of adding layers of magic over the everyday world in a way that makes me feel connected to something larger than myself. And tea time is one of my favourite times to daydream, precisely because my senses are grounded and my mind is free to wander. So I drink tea and I daydream, and I write some of those daydreams down into stories and poems, and I share some of those stories, and I make visual art, like paintings and block prints, which bring small facets of that daydreamed world to life. I do all this in the hopes of creating more beauty and a sense of sanctuary in this world. And that, altogether, is the deepest essence of Brightwitch. Samantha's final question for me was, do you craft the tea yourself? Again, yes and no. When I first started Brightwitch at the end of 2018, I was grinding up spices and herbs and experimenting with flavours, mixing it all up myself to share with friends and family. Then I started looking into the legal logistics of turning it into a proper registered food business, and it was a lot. I needed a proper registered kitchen space, I needed to invest in all the blend ingredients and the packaging and the labelling, and space to store it, and I didn't have the equipment to add the kinds of flavourings that I most wanted to work with. At the time, I just didn't have the resources to bootstrap it all myself, especially with a full-time day job. So I went to work, finding a fulfillment partner who offered blends with ingredients and flavours very much like the ones I was trying to create myself, and who was also willing to add edible sparkles to the blends. So I've been working with them for nearly 3 years now, and they've been an absolute blessing for getting my little tea business off the ground. Over the past couple of years, I've also been working to establish my own registered tea workspace to work independently. It's been a ridiculously challenging journey. Like, I just did not expect tea, of all things, to be so logistically challenging. But I had been trying to do this while working full-time and during multiple hard lockdowns and regional restrictions which affected supply chains and shipping times and various other setbacks which have made the road that much longer and bumpier. But as it stands now, I rent a kitchen space where I can put blends together myself. I can store and package and ship products myself, which is fantastic because now I can ship more easily and cost-effectively to more regions. So I ship around Australia and also to New Zealand, Europe, North America, and the UK. I reduced my hours earlier this year to work part-time in my day job as a digital designer and web developer, which gives me most of the week now to work on Brightwitch, blending and packing teas, posting orders, writing stories, making art, and videos like this one, and working on brand new original blend recipes again. Ones that are all my own creation from ingredients and flavours that I've chosen. I'm experimenting with different methods of adding natural flavourings to tea to get really flavoursome brews, and playing with different types of sparkle dusts for different pearlescent effects. I actually have 2 new original blend recipes in the pipeline that I'm super excited about. Some orders are still packed by my fulfillment partner in North America, as shipping is faster for that region, but my bundled products and newer blends I ship out myself from Melbourne here in Australia. Lara from Instagram asks, what do you like most about making your own teas? Honestly, there are so many things that are just so satisfying about making your own tea blends. I particularly love the smell of the ingredients. If you've ever ground cloves and cinnamon in a mortar and pestle, you'll know it's almost like bathing in aroma. It just smells delicious and is so incredibly soothing. I love learning about the medicinal properties of different herbs and then crafting blend recipes for specific purposes. I'm actually working on a blend for voice support at the moment, as I've been taking singing lessons for a few years, and would love my own tea just for singing. I love falling down rabbit holes learning about different roots, herbs, and flowers, and then actually being able to brew them up and try them for myself. I love playing around with different ratios of ingredients. It feels almost like alchemy. And I love the satisfaction of knowing I found a good blend recipe when my guinea pig tea taster boyfriend is sad his teacup is empty. Thank you so much for joining me for this little arty tea time AMA. I'm off to go refill my cup. I hope your week ahead is as magical as you are. Until next time, my loves.